Oh, fucking finally.
Now, if you're just tuning in, you must be thinking, these guys are crazy. What are they staring at that pile of seaweed for?
Sure is what I'm thinking.
Well, what you're actually looking at is an octopus. These guys are masters of camouflage. They can change color and skin texture. Some have even been observed walking on two arms and imitating a coconut.
They're nuts, all right.
Now, they mostly feed off of mussels, herring, and crab.
Expensive taste, huh?
When they're hungry, in some sort of danger, they haul some serious tail.
No, they haul all eight arms.
That's right. And if we're lucky, we may get to see what's called jet propulsion. It's the only time you'll see an octopus go fast. And I mean real fast.
Really intelligent creatures. Really, really... Hey, where'd it go?
Yeah. I wouldn't recommend keeping these guys as pets. They often find their way out of captivity.
Really intelligent creatures.
It's no longer about nations, ideologies, or ethnicity. It's an endless series of proxy battles fought by mercenaries and machines. War, and its consumption of life, has become a well-oiled machine. War has changed. ID tag soldiers carry ID tag weapons, use ID tag gear. Nanomachines inside their bodies enhance and regulate their abilities. Genetic control, information control, emotion control, battlefield control. Everything is monitored and kept under control. War has changed. The age of deterrence has become the age of control. All in the name of averting catastrophe from weapons of mass destruction. And he who controls the battlefield controls history. Changed. When the battlefield is under total control, war becomes routine.
Yeah. We'll try and get no kills, no alerts, but not promise.
And try not to run into any gecko along the way.
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of sitting down watching on this one. Which I don't mind. I love the cutscenes in this game. In the trailer, I feel like I was in the trailer.
Thank you.
Ooh. Excuse me.
Snake, we've got to go. You've got an old friend waiting for you.
Otacon.
Need to check those fucking subtitles on.
The test
results.
Proteome analysis was positive. But the mRNA analysis turned up negative. Wrinkled skin, the hardened arteries. Your early aging symptoms look like classic Werner's syndrome. But none of the tests were able to pinpoint the cause.
So?
Well, judging by how rapidly the aging has progressed, I'd say...
a year at best, right?
Snake, let's try another doctor.
It won't make any difference. I'm not an ordinary man to begin with. Not to mention Fox Dye.
You're right. But we don't know where Naomi is.
I'm not a colonel anymore, Snake.
I figured the only place I'd see you dressed like that would be at your daughter's wedding. What are you doing these days?
I'm working for an organization under the UN Security Council. The analysis and assessment staff of the PMC Oversight and Inspection Committee.
Yeah, I remember the resolution being passed a few years ago.
Snake, I came across some information in my work. We found him. In the Middle East.
What?
I'll explain along the way. We've got to stop him. Now. Before it's too late.
Liquid's made his move. We found him.
He's preparing to unleash his insurrection. Liquid is lying in wait in a Middle Eastern war zone. Track him down.
Only two eggs today? psychologist must have taken the day off. 7 8 9 2 5 9 0 3 6 0 3 3 0 5 3 0 5 4 8 8 2 4 6 6 5 2.
Go make a drink. I got a really fucking sore throat. Ooh. Oh, it's my controller. There we go. Rumble started to do my head in as well.
This is Snake. Do you read me?
What's the situation?
I'm just inside the city limits. This place is crawling with lizards.
Ah, AT Corps' unmanned bipedal weapons. Officially designated Irving by the US military. They've spread like wildfire among the PMCs. There are more of those things now in service than tanks. They've got tough armor plating and are highly agile to boot. Your best bet is to stay out of their sights.
Unmanned. Pretty soon they'll have put living, breathing soldiers out of work.
Even so, that's an awful lot of gecko for this scenario. Their numbers exceed the war price for that region. It must have something to do with Liquid's arrival on the scene.
You really think he's here?
You'll have to find the Army's operatives and ask them yourself. Oh, and Snake, I went ahead and used the Mark II to scout out the area before your arrival. You'll find it up ahead.
Mark II?
It's a remote mobile terminal. Sonny and I built it. The Mark II will provide you with a map of the area as well as any battle situation data. You should find it before you do anything else.
Okay, got it.
The rendezvous point is marked on your map. I'll be waiting for you there.
Duck camo, yeah, something new to this game. Blending with the environment. Pretty sick. I played this game when it first came out, and it fucking amazed me, the graphics especially. And it still holds up now, saying that. Full Metal Gear game has been really good looking. But yeah, I read the shit about this game in magazines before it came out. And it delivered. I loved it. It's been a while though since I played it. 3 years or so. You put on the floor, is it?
Avoid unnecessary combat whenever possible. In this war, neither side is your enemy. There's no point whatsoever in you getting into a fight. Got it?
Okay. Alright. If you can stop Snake itching his back or like breaking his back if you just move him a little bit. Stops his animation. Completely forgot he does that. Nice little touch. Considering he's old as shit. Ooh, fuck. Because we're playing on hard, they're going to be a lot more aware. Not be careful, really. That dude's going to see me if I stay. I'm talking a bit quietly, but my throat is fucking burning. It's that weather. Bullet sponge.
Acting under contact alert.
Please come that way.
The praying mantis PMC recently restored governmental control of this sector. Utilizing arms tech nerving unmanned vehicles, praying mantis conclusively delivered a swift and decisive outcome. We hope you'll consider the praying mantis solution for all your future combat needs.
Thing is, every time I play this game, I always look forward the most to go into Act 4. My favourite act, by far.
Huh? I hear footsteps.
Checks I'm in. CQC. Controls. Because I'm playing MGS3, I can't remember if it's the same. Is there not? Button layout. Oh, I've got the book by here. Have a look. Oh no, I don't have the book. Oh fuck it. I just have to leave. That counts as an alert.
You can pick up guns dropped by both the militia and the PMCs.
Well.
Remember though, PMC weapons are locked. You can't use them. If only there was some way to get rid of the locks.
Okay. There is a trophy for doing some in here, but I don't know if I get caught. I think I'll shoot it off, but I'm not risking that.
Snake, press the crawl button while running to execute a roll. Rolling can help you dodge enemy attacks and get past small gaps and obstacles.
Huh? Enemy!
Decent evasion. It shows how careful you gotta be. Need you to go down there, sir. Good boy.
Snake, it's me.
Huh? Otacon.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Snake. Allow me to introduce Metal Gear Mark II.
Metal Gear?
That's right. Just like Rex.
I'm gonna get all of them as well for the trophy.
But this gear's not a weapon. It's a remote mobile terminal designed to provide you with operational support.
Where are you?
I'm in the Nomad. Where else? I'll be watching you through the Mark II.
Wish I was good with gadgets.
Hey, I'll be with you in spirit. Anyway, because you had to dress up as a militiaman, I had the Mark II bring you some goodies. Starting with this. Put it on your left eye.
Looks like an eye patch.
I call it the Solid Eye. It's an all-purpose goggle that displays radar images and other data in 3D. You can also switch it over to light-amplifying night vision.
Huh.
like they've got the government's PMC troops beat, at least in numbers.
And this is their home turf.
Snake, I know this is a sneaking mission, but you'll need to protect yourself.
Thank you.
An operator.
I installed a suppressor. And here's a tranquilizer gun.
How thoughtful.
It predates the implementation of the system. By some miracle, it was never recycled. It's getting tough these days finding decent guns that aren't controlled. Follow you wherever you go, like this. I'll activate stealth so it doesn't attract any attention. If you need it, just bring up the start button menu.
Got it.
Snake, the informants who said they saw liquid here should be a little further up. Head for the rendezvous point. I've placed a mark on the radar in the upper right corner of the solid eye. It's a war zone out there. Stay on your toes.
Snake, it's kind of a schlep, but I've sent you data on an alternate route. Follow the mark on your radar.
Right.
Charge!
Charge! I'm still gonna try and get no kills. This is trying to kill these guys. It's best to keep them distracted.
It's pretty dark in there. Switch the solid eye to night vision mode.
Don't move.
It's the enemy!
Thank you.
There's a lot of those fucking tracks as well. Get like every emblem in the game, I think. A disguise. I think we can just run past them now.
Pretty sweet, huh? Oh, hold it. Watch where you're pointing that thing.
Who are you?
Neither enemy nor friend. Voila.
You're not with the militia, and you're not PMC.
I'm a weapons wholesaler. All shapes, all sizes. But there's no need to worry, because all my shit's been laundered.
Laundered?
You see, I take ID guns like the PMCs use and make some mods. Then you can use them without having to match IDs. In other words, I'm a gun launderer. You can call me Drebin.
Drebin?
Yeah, they use that for all of us.
There are more of you?
All over the world. Not that I ever met any of them personally. Me, I'm Drebin number 893. You ain't a registered PMC employee, are you? You need a guy like me. consider it a welcome gift. Take it. The M4, the official carbine model used by the U.S. Army, developed from the M16 service rifle. This one's a top-of-the-line model, real popular with the big PMCs. High precision, not like that government-issue shit. It's, free-floating, of course. Relax, that barrel's clean.
Is the Hider CQC compatible?
The beauty of this sucker is that it's got a lot of customizable parts. Change it up the way you want to meet your everyday needs.
Flip-up sight, rail system. Not bad.
Yeah, well, you know, I get a lot of noobs around here. And if you need them, I got a wide selection of aftermarket parts as well.
The frame's pretty rigid. No rattle.
Go ahead. Give her a squeeze.
Trigger.
Really? That's weird.
What's weird?
No stamina.
I got it. I bet you're using an older generation of nanomachines.
Older generation?
Sometimes they don't really jive with the new system.
Seriously, who are you?
Whoa. Slow down. Oh, yeah. My day job's working at AT Security. I'm in charge of production control. So I get my hands on all the ID chips before they even register. Have a sip. It's a side of AT the public don't see. From the looks of it, you ain't with any state army. But you ain't exactly green, neither. You've got last-gen nanomachines, so I'm guessing former U.S. Army. I don't know what you're here for, but you want to be well-equipped, am I right? So, can we talk business or what? You won't regret it.
What's your take on Emoticon?
I don't particularly like the guy. But it looks like we'll need his help with those ID guns. Sonny's been doing a little sleuthing for us. Drebin, a well-known gun launderer in war economy circles.
Drebin's always reminded me of Motherfucker Jones.
Selling black market firearms
but he hasn't
to small
always,
PMCs
but since I've seen
militia.
Horrible Bosses,
Somalia,
I don't know
the
why.
Balkans, Lebanon, Darfur, Chechnya, Timor, Peru, the Punjab, Kashmir, Colombia. This guy really gets around.
How's he pull it off, anyway?
You can create a non-ID gun by replacing the ID recognition chip with a counterfeit version. This enables you to bypass the ID recognition process and use the gun. The problem is that there's still a record of the chip being replaced on the system side. Drebin's an employee of AT Security. He must have connections on the inside erasing records for him.
You think the Patriots are involved somehow?
I'm not so sure. If the Patriots were running the system from behind the scenes, then a weasel like Drebin would be a real pain in their collective ass.
Can he be trusted?
Remember, Drebin's a green collar. He makes his living off the war economy. He doesn't let emotions get in the way of business, and he never gets his own hands dirty. The only thing he trusts is money. I share your concern, but what if we keep him at arm's length? Use him only to get intel and the supplies we need. Keep it strictly business.
All right.
So, we ready to make a deal or what? Okay then, let's talk business. This is a war zone. There's product coming in here by the truckload. And you'll be picking up a lot of guns in the field, I'm sure. Whatever guns you don't need, I'll take and buy them off you. That'll earn you points you can cash in for services.
Like what?
I'll launder your ID guns. No more locks. And I can also sell you the guns I've got in stock. Let me show you. To ensure you can use 9ID guns, I'm gonna have to suppress the old nanomachines you got in you. Otherwise, they'll interfere with the system. Here, stick yourself with this. It's full of suppressor nanomachines. Relax, it won't hurt. You're scared of needles or something? See? No sweat. Now you can use non-ID guns, no problem. Hey, be nice to our guest.
Such a weird thing, which fits the gameplay and the story.
Step outside.
This is obviously just a gameplay gimmick, but they've managed to woven it into the story, which is pretty sick.
There you see? No problem.
Hey.
From now on, when you pick up an ID gun that says lock, you just let me know. You name it, I can launder it. Of course, it'll cost you. The going rate depends on the war price at the time. Man, I gotta give this shit a rest.
Looks like you're doing pretty well for yourself.
You might say that. What with the war economy and all, and the system clamping down on things. System codes are the law now, and controls essentially absolute. Paving the way for fat profits, if you're willing to bend the law. Demand keeps on growing thanks to the war economy. I sell ID guns to the PMCs and state armies, and naked guns to terrorist groups and paramilitaries. And these ID guns can't be sold on the black market. System's practically a license for us arms dealers to print money. Privatizing the military's made the PMCs big and bloated. The fatter the PMCs get, the line between civilian and soldier is gonna get real blurry. Sooner or later, the whole damn human race is gonna be green collars. More like, we're all gonna be fighting proxy wars. But hey, this war economy puts the food on my table. You're a green collar too, aren't you? Yeah, it's in your eyes. You've seen a lot of combat.
What makes you think you know me?
Nothing to be ashamed of. I'm the same way. I grew up here too. I got no interest in the outside world. All right then, if you need me, holla. We specialize in speedy service. Catch my drift. I have you.
Love that monkey.
I know what you're thinking, but Drebin does have a point. The world depends on war, on the war economy. Can you imagine what would happen if war just disappeared overnight?
Otacon, you and Drebin both mentioned something about a war price earlier. What did you mean by that?
It's a kind of market price. One that fluctuates according to demand, not only for PMCs and military industry, but for the production, distribution, and energy supply networks that support them. It's been growing by leaps and bounds, and investors are really starting to take notice. As the fighting in any given area becomes increasingly intense and prolonged, the war price goes up. No doubt Drebin's rates are linked to that war price. The longer and bloodier a battle becomes, the higher service prices are going to get. To put it another way, the quieter things are, the better the bargains. Snake, we'll use the Mark II to deal with Drebin from here on out. He's what you might call a street vendor. The Mark II can act as a kind of delivery boy, connect you with him. I'm adding a Drebin menu item to the Mark II's weapon menu. Whenever you pick up multiple units of the same weapon, any extras will automatically be sold to Drebin. Any ammo that's inside gets added to your cash. In other words, you keep the ammo, and the weapon itself gets traded to Drebin for points.
I see.
You can then use the points you've earned to unlock ID guns or buy new weapons.
Sounds good.
We should assume Drebin has other agents collecting guns for him besides you, Snake. You know, freelance green collars who collect weapons in exchange for services?
Guess I'll have to rely on him for now.
Okay. Now go meet up with our informants, Rat Patrol.
Alright, let's do it.
Snake, hurry and get to the rendezvous point with our informants. First, you'll have to get to the other side of that collapsed building.
Nice.
The only way across is straight through. Careful, Snake. The walls could come down any second.
Oh, they will.
Yeah, I can see him.
Perfect. We can pick him off from here.
Damn it!
Spotted! Return fire!
Playboy magazines.
Who's there?
Go away! I'm not done yet!
Stop right there!
No.
Get back here!
There's a lot of tears in it, then.
GasSnake. Hurry to the rendezvous point. Your radar is marked with which way to go.
There's lots of ways you can get through it. Ooh.
Sent reinforcements. Now their defensive line is a lot thicker. It's gonna be tougher to break through. That striker will be shooting at you, too. Stay on your toes. It might be best to avoid that area altogether if you can.
Alright, it's here, I gotta be careful. Fucking blocked in my enemies. mines in here. Him. Fucking seen that. If I can see now coming.
Drop your weapon! Drop your weapon!
All right. Here.
Easy now. Don't move!
You haven't even taken the safety off, rookie.
I forgot to turn the subtitles on.
Careful! I'm no rookie.
Again.
I'm a 10-year vet.
How the hell did you ever survive 10 years?
Don't move! CQC. Real big boss, huh? Lower your weapon! Slowly now. I wouldn't try anything funny if I were you.
Fox.
Snake? Snake!
Meryl.
Is that you? What happened to your face?
Accelerated aging. They don't know the cause.
Oh my God.
Meryl, you're my informant at the U.S. military.
And you must be the inspector sent by the UN. Akiba!
Commander! Sorry.
This is Rat Patrol Team 01. We're with the CID, one of the bodies investigating PMC activity.
First hounds, now rats. Here, you can have this back. What is your problem? You okay? Stomach pains? Diarrhea?
It's been 4 days since Liquid arrived in the area. And since then, this woman's been with him. She doesn't look like a combatant. Probably some kind of advisor. Maybe a scientist.
So, you're the commander of this O-1 unit.
Why? Something wrong with that? Here, I'll introduce you to the team. That's Ed, our radio man and sniper. Sleeping giant is Jonathan. Don't stand behind him. He hates it when people go around his back. Finally, Johnny. Everybody just calls him Akiba.
Commander, I've finished installing the sensors.
Okay, Akiba. Anyway.
Up.
Maybe it's because someone taught me well. A certain legendary hero who suddenly disappeared. You quit the unit. Me? I never gave up on you. Or on Foxhound. Back then, I just wanted you to accept me. I wanted you to turn around. See who I was. But I've put the past behind. I'm done playing little love games. So, what are you here for?
Threat assessment. The PMCs.
Really? Because I heard a rumor there's an assassin out there targeting their leader.
Well, that's some rumor. I'm only here because the UN wants me to assess the impact and effects of PMCs on their refugee protection efforts.
That's all?
More than enough for a retired vet like me.
I know he's plotting an insurrection. But as long as AT Security's system is in place, there's no way he'll succeed.
How can you be so sure?
They've implemented a system that monitors in real time every single soldier engaged in combat action, whether he's State Army or PMC. Each individual soldier has been fully ID tagged with nanomachines injected into their bodies for that purpose. The nanomachines keep track of the soldiers and their real-time personal data 24 hours a day. They monitor each man's position, movement speed, reserve ammo, firing accuracy, wounds, rations, water intake and supply, sweat secreted, heart rate, blood pressure and sugar levels, oxygen. All the data gathered on body condition, on sensory organ data showing pain and fear, data on every internal response within the body. All of it is collected by an AI at the system's core. This data is monitored at HQ to enable command to make quicker, more precise, more rational decisions. It also enables crisis management for each individual soldier. It's being used by the US military, by state armies in allied countries, by PMCs. Even police agencies are starting to adopt it. Unless they agree to implement the system, PMCs aren't permitted to send troops anywhere.
You've got these system nanomachines and you too.
Of course. Our unit plays by the rules, same as everybody else. It was creepy at first, knowing you're being watched 24/7, but I've gotten used to it. It gives us a lot of advantages in the field, too. We get a clearer picture of what's going on around us, so there's less confusion during missions. And our nanomachines communicate with each other, making teamwork a lot smoother. And that's not all the system does for us. It's also a security guarantee against the PMCs.
Security guarantee?
That's right. The PMCs are combat groups without states or ideologies. They're not fighting out of nationalism or for a cause. They don't care why the war is being fought. They're just bodies fighting on someone else's behalf. They're mercenaries, a commodity. So it's easy to imagine them betraying their clients by joining the enemy or refusing to fight or committing humanitarian atrocities. To keep these things in check, they ensured that no one can use firearms or military vehicles without the proper system ID. It's true for every piece of equipment out there. So even if the PMCs tried to mount a terrorist attack or coup d'etat, their weapons and equipment would automatically be locked out. They wouldn't be able to move, attack, or engage in combat of any kind. And there's more. All the data on their position, personnel, and combat strength is leaked to us by the nanomachines. Even if they managed to circumvent the system by getting the nanomachines out of each soldier's body, they'd be losing their IDs in the process, so they couldn't use their weapons.
And the Patriots are behind this.
Lalilulelo, what are you talking about?
Never mind. So this system is foolproof, huh?
Completely. They call it SOP.
Sons of the Patriots.
The AI that controls it is a tightly guarded secret, both at Arms Tech Security, where it was developed, and at the Pentagon. There's no way a third party could get control of it.
I just met a guy who said he can launder ID guns. The system does have holes.
There can't be more than a few hundred of those gun launderers. It's just a grassroots movement. It's not like they can affect the entire PMC war machine. Anyway, Liquid would have had to register as a PMC in the system to assemble an army that massive. His PMCs might even exceed the US military in terms of numbers, but as long as they're registered, their soldiers' activities are constantly being monitored. So long as the U.S. responds immediately when Liquid makes his move, we can take them down by force.
By force, huh?
When Arsoc heard about Liquid's plans, they sent us to sniff around the PMCs. Even with this SOP keeping an eye on things, there are always trouble spots to deal with in the field. Disorderly conduct, disobeying orders, contract violations. We act as backup for the system by monitoring the soldiers. PMC inspections are always carried out on the battlefield. That's why we're authorized to carry and use weapons. We've lost 5 inspection teams in the past few months alone. They were all undercover, inside Liquid's PMCs.
Then, if you got caught...
we'd be exterminated like rats. But we're smarter than that. We've been mingling with the PMCs, and after 3 months of searching God knows how many battlefields, we finally tracked him down. When we reported that we'd found Liquid, our superiors ordered us to provide the UN investigators with intel. But I didn't know it'd be you.
Didn't the Colonel tell you he was sending me?
Colonel? Don't tell me it's Campbell!
Yeah.
He put you up to this?
You didn't know.
You've gotta be kidding! You expect me to work with my uncle?
Meryl.
This is bullshit. He's not my father. Little violation of the need-to-know rule.
Then, why are you still calling him Uncle?
You're still calling him Colonel.
He's your father.
As far as I'm concerned, we're still uncle and niece. I will never forgive that womanizing piece of shit.
Meryl!
He remarried.
Really?
His new wife's about my age. I hear she's even got a kid. It's as if he's given up on making up with his own daughter. Men. Selfish, egotistical pigs.
Commander!
What is it?
There's 20 of them, and they're not from that PMC praying mantis either. It's the Frog.
His private troops.
Oh, crap. This is not good.
Were you being followed?
No.
Akiba!
They might have seen the reflection off my scope lens. Whoa, wait. Hang on. You guys think it was my fault? Oh. No. Oh, it wasn't my fault. I swear. It wasn't my fault. Oh, man. Oh, look,
Dumbass! We're moving out!
Meryl, where's Liquid?
At a camp up ahead. I'll fill you in later.
All right.
If we're still alive. Follow me.
Thank you.
contact. These guys are with Liquid's private army. Shoot first, think later. We'll use the stairs and get out through the back door on the first floor. We'll change the route as necessary. I'm on point. Stay close. Got it?
Got it.
Akiba, breathe deep.
Got it.
We've got a real live legendary hero with us. Try not to choke. Move!
Thank you.
Kojima's been knocked out.
We're gonna have to go down the rope.
Thank you.
The nanomachine network inside each unit member's body lets us share each other's senses. They can see what I see. And it helps control pain.
Is that part of the system, too?
With SOP, my team can literally operate as one. Well, except for a certain someone who's not much of a team player. So, what do you think? Is your age of heroes finally over?
I'm no hero. Never was. Never will be.
You haven't changed at all, Snake. But your body. Are you gonna be all right?
This getup doubles as a muscle suit. I can still get around.
Liquid's camp is up ahead. I'll mark it on your map.
Thanks.
Akiba! One man's blunder can compromise the whole team.
I'm sorry, Commander.
Be careful, Snake.
Liquid is.
Yeah, I'm confirming the location. It's to the north of where you are. Meryl's really changed, hasn't she, Snake? She's a lot more self-assured.
I wonder how much of that has to do with the system. The senses you used to develop through extended training and experience can now be obtained without even working for them. Seems once you're under the system's control, you don't even need experience at all. It even beats that VR training that was all the rage a few years back.
Yeah. The growing need for PMCs has led to the creation of a more reliable, cost-effective supply of elite soldiers. It's also made the child soldier phenomenon more problematic than ever.
Can the nanomachines do anything to counteract post-traumatic stress disorder?
Good question. They might provide a degree of psychological stability.
You think so? That geek kid, Akiba, he was really starting to lose it.
And technologically, the system should be able to optimize each soldier's personality traits.
And that big guy, he didn't seem to be feeling any pain at all.
Augmenting the soldier's existing experience and psychological fortitude.
But a soldier's gotta have more than that.
The times have changed, Snake. Just like Meryl. Snake, hurry to the PMC camp. Based on what Meryl told us, Liquid should be there.
Okay, time to head for the surface.
Thank you. Back me up!
What's going on?
Move!
we're getting close to the end of the act now. Hopefully I'm feeling better more in the week so I can do more of this. Yeah, this is probably the easiest game to get the big boss rank on. Even though they discover you pretty quick when they see you, everything else is pretty easy.
Check it out.
Yes, sir.
Otacon, wait here.
Hey,
it. Snake, you're here to kill Liquid, aren't you?
That's the mission. Are you going to stop me?
My mission is to inspect the PMCs. I'm not in a position to take action. All I can do is stand by and watch. I can't help you, understand? I'm a peacekeeper, here to keep order.
Understood.
Oh, are you serious? The game's froze. Crash code.
Too long.
Liquid.
Rejoice! We're not copies of our father, after all. We are free of the shackles of fate. Snake. Brother. We are free. Watch as I surpass my own origin.
Snake, if you won't be a prisoner to fate, then go. Fulfill your destiny.
Yeah, that one continue. I died while I was making my way back here because the game fucking froze. No kills. Sick.